the American college experience, known to be one of the most memorable chapters of life, where people discover who they are and what they like, full of eventful memories and stories that will be talked about for years to come. Sadly, it's something I never had the chance to experience because I went directly to Madrid, Spain, straight out of high school. Did I regret missing out on this American college experience? Yes. Fast forward to present day, do I still regret missing out?
No, not a single moment. Although I went directly to dental school in Spain right out of high school, instead of going down the conventional route by attending undergrad in the United States, I don't regret it one bit. You might be wondering why. Well, let me explain, but to do so, I have to take you all the way back to day one.
It is September 18th, and it's the first day of school. This is my dorm. I'm probably gonna look back on this and laugh, actually, because I'm gonna be here for 5 years. I'm actually currently studying dentistry right now, and after this 5 years, I'm gonna be a dentist. So let's begin the journey today.
Being my first year abroad with no Americans around, I was completely out of my comfort zone.
I just finished like my first week and it's tough, man. I like come straight home and I just study.
The way people interacted, partied, the music they enjoyed, heck, even the way they greeted each other were not what I was used to.
People in Madrid, they stay out late, way later than like California, but
my first year was difficult, not only because of culture shock, but my studies as well. Since I went directly to dental school, learning nothing except scientific subjects.
10-page paper, 43 questions. Bacteria and plus
became white with some brown in it. I'm gonna save this shit.
I found myself spending all my time studying in my shoebox of a dorm.
I passed my biochem exam!
I passed completely
and boom!
Guess what? I passed! I passed! I'm gonna go out tonight.
I recall going out to the local bar probably a total of 5 times the entire year.
Here's a playlist you might like.
See, check that shit out. Cheers.
Every night, I'd see all my friends from high school living their best life. Meanwhile, I would be doing the exact opposite.
This is just my normal day of studying. For the past week, I've been just doing this. Wake up in the morning, then I take a hit of my juice. It's my birthday today.
It's like I've been here studying.
I made a couple friends.
These are my friends.
But little did I know, what I was experiencing was just the start of something beautiful.
Fuck this place! But it is kind of sad because like I'm never gonna come home again.
As you can see,
I'm in this room and it's like, whoa, desk.
But little do they know, it says Nick was here. I should have done it like the other direction.
And by the end of my first year, I had broadened my horizons and began to love what I initially hated. And without even noticing it, time started to go by real fast. And you know what they say, when time goes by fast, that means you're having fun.
Yeah.
I had the chance to try foods I've never tasted before, learn about new cultures I had no previous knowledge about, visit parts of the world I would have never thought about going to, opened my heart to the beauty of music I never thought I'd love, exposed myself to languages I've never heard, and best of all, I got out of my comfort zone by interacting with people with completely different backgrounds, and was fortunate enough to acquire a precious family from around the world.
We are back in Paris after a year. Remember us from San Jorge, from the residence, from Madrid, from Malasaña? Well, a year later, we're back in Paris. You thought we were never gonna see each other after uni. Little did you know, we were brothers and we will never gonna live without each other.
Ayub, the buff dude, who looks like a dick at first glance, but when you get to know him, he's surprisingly nice, extremely smart, and one of the most dedicated people I know, and not as old as he looks. Ryan, one of the nicest, smartest, and stylish people I know. He has a skill where he can understand every language in the world, and he never fails to understand a joke, even when no one gets it. Paul, he's quiet at first. From the outside, he looks mysterious. You're always wondering what he's thinking about, and it's normal to hate him right off the bat for that. Or maybe that was just me, because he barely spoke English when I first met him. But when you get to know him, he's not as quiet as he may seem, and he really gives no fucks. Omar. If there's one person I could think of with the purest soul, I would say his name. From the 5 years I've known him, he's never showed any signs of greed or hate. He's loyal and will always have your back. With these people, I grew as a person, went through the worst and the best of times. From the months of stressful exam periods not seeing daylight for months straight, ordering the same food 3 times a day, to venturing to different parts of the world and becoming doctors together. So here's to every moment, every challenge, and every success we've shared throughout this journey.
You need someone to hold you tight, and you think love is to pray, but I'm sorry, I don't pray that way.
The one thing I learned from my unconventional experience is that of course no one likes change. I recall telling myself that I couldn't wait for these 5 years to fly by so I can finally go back to America and continue my life exactly where it left off. Now I can't seem to leave the very place I dreaded 5 years prior. If you're in a stage of change in your life, the one advice I can give to you is that time heals everything. If you feel that there isn't anyone similar to you, just be patient. Because with time, the like-minded individuals will gravitate to you, like they did to me. In the end, I'm genuinely grateful I made the decision to go to Europe. 5 years ago, I would have never thought these words would be coming out of my mouth. But here I am. Happy that I went, and I wouldn't have wanted it any other way. So thank you for the lifelong family I acquired from around the world. And here's a little message I wrote to Madrid.
Dear Madrid, where do I begin? Allow me to start off by confessing that I didn't like you at first. Yet, as the years unfolded, you became an integral part of my life. And with time, I began to fall in love with you. Although my time with you has ended, a piece of my heart will forever remain with you. Anytime I go back to visit, I know it will never be the same. For it wasn't the location that made Madrid, Madrid. It was the souls of the people that brought life into the city. Sadly, those very souls have dispersed across the globe, and I know they won't be there when I return. So I guess a fragment of me now resides scattered across the world. I hold you close to my heart, and offer my gratitude for the countless stories and memories you've gifted me. But the time has come for this chapter of my life to reach its final page and for us to part ways. You shall forever reside within the depths of my soul and express to others through the very essence of my personality. You will internally remain alive within me, forever etched in the fabric of my memories. Love, Nick.
First day of school. first day of college. By the way, I'm 18 years old. I just finished high school. And I love making videos.
Why'd you decide to do this today?
You know, I needed a little bit of money.
So can I see a little bit of like something something? Oh, damn.
Yeah.
This is a nice head of hair. We should go another room.
Okay.
Hey, follow me. This is the room. Barber Omar. Are you a little nervous?
I'm very nervous.
Okay.
Hey, let's knock on this door. This is my first time.
Welcome to Omar's Barbers.
Omar's Barbers? Mm-hmm. Ah, who are these people?
Yo,
very nice, actually.
What the fuck?
God.
What the fuck?
Oh, yeah, like here.
I feel like that's pretty good, man. It's definitely worth it.
Oh, yes. Okay.
A little action
for later.
You know what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying.
You're still watching? If you're still watching, you probably enjoyed this video. I just wanted to say this video has been one of the hardest and most time-consuming videos I've ever made since it's been 6 years in the planning. And I had to organize all my pictures, horizontal and vertical videos from my iPhone into albums from the last 6 years, as well as all my pictures and videos from my camera. And for those of you who know me, I take a lot of pictures and a lot of videos. Let alone the fact in second year I got robbed and they stole all my cameras, lenses, and hard drives, so I wasn't actually planning on making this video with iPhone footage, but I had to work with what I had. So if you like this video and you want to see videos similar to this, go ahead and click this video right here. It's pretty cool.